Welcome to the Surf Engine website, the newly redesigned website to reflect the mobile app and be actually a tool to help you find surf buddies and your perfect surf spots all around the world. I just want to take you on a quick tour, show you what's available here, and hopefully you can sign up and join or use it as a resource to find waves around you that are your perfect kind of wave and around the world. So here you can go up here to find surfers or go down here to surf buddies and look for surf buddies that kind of have similar surf skills and surf styles as you. Was kind of my intention on creating the site. There's a few people that have signed up so far, but really I'm trying to grow this and I'm going to do some things later, hopefully, to promote it and some more people will join, starting with this little video here. Basically, you can search for surfers by gender, by their surf experience level to kind of get someone on your level, or maybe even more advanced than you that you could learn from. Looking at surfers, look at the surfboards that they ride. If they go to longboard spots, they probably have a longboard, and so you can find a longboard surfing buddy, things like that. And then you can also search by your home break, search for people that surf local surf spots near you, or your local town, your city, or your community. All of that can be put in your profile, and people can, and other surfers can search for you by that, as well as your favorite regular surf spots to find surf buddies that really like to go and surf the same places that you do. This is just kind of for fun, just you kind of what your surfing style is, whether you're a long wave cruiser or a ripper and a shredder. I'm more of a long wave cruiser and a fast and furious is really more my style or what I can do. And then surfing frequency. If you're a weekend warrior and all you can surf on weekends, it's cool to have buddies, surf buddies that like to surf on the weekends. Or for me, I love surfing in sunny afternoons. So you can always say what kind of surf time you're looking for. I just can't do dawn patrol. Sorry. I've tried. Maybe in Hawaii or something, if I just stay up all night, I could do it. But yeah, so I love surfing during the sun patrol is what I call it. And then you can also put your sand bucket spots, surf places that you want to visit. So maybe you can search for people that want to go to the same places that you do, and you can start a surf trip. And then kind of places that you have completed and checked off your list. You can maybe ask people, hey, what was good about surfing X, Y, and Z area? It's just kind of a thing to do there. And then there's also just you can put your favorite bands or restaurants, bars, your side hustle, occupation, and other interests. So you connect with other surfers that have other similar interests as you as well. So when you do all this, you search and then you find people with your criteria. But if you're lazy like a lot of people and you just want to search for something in any of those fields and you just have one thing to search for, I can just search for, hey, someone that lives by Tourmaline or surfs Tourmaline a lot. And I can go down here and then I search for the surfers that have Tourmaline as their local hang. And of course, you find me. And this is my other alternative profile that I was using to practice with myself and testing the site out. So, and you go to click the profile, you actually have to be logged in because that I just wanted to keep this community private. And so when you click on my profile, in order to see it, you're going to have to log in and sign up with an account. I'd be stoked if you guys sign up and create an account. Hold on before I log in, and then I'll get back to you right here. Finish the tour. So now you can see my profile here. I have kind of a cover image here just showing the different places I've surfed, some of the more epic places. Mexico, I believe this was Cabo, Old Man's. This was Punta Mita La Lancha, and this was Scorpion Bay right here on the right. So the main image, this is a profile pic of my face so people can recognize me when they see me. You can link out to social media profiles that you might want to promote and connect to. I linked out to my Instagram and LinkedIn. And then this is just my profile. It just gives my first name and last name. If you don't want it visible, you don't have to have it visible. The last name, and then just kind of like my nickname, gender, my experience level. I liked having it experienced and needs improvement because while I am experienced, I'm really not that good. But I know what I need to do. So that's one of my levels that I created here. And then just the kind of surfboards I surf, my home break of Tourmaline. You can see my t-shirt here. Tourmaline local surf crew. Yeah, so that's my home break. My favorite regular surf spots are, the slow, easy rollers like Sanook, Dhoni Beach, too. I don't get up there that often, but those are my ideal perfect waves here in San Diego. I like to surf long waves fast, and then just weekly I surf. And you can just kind of get, all the information here. It's pretty basic. So that's just kind of like the way to find surfers and connect with them. You can also create an event if you'd like to, host like a meetup. So it's kind of like meetup.com in that way as well. And then kind of like see your connections. And then if you do write any blogs, you'll have your blogs listed here of the things that you've written. And then photos. And then there's also groups that you can join, and then forums that are a part of those groups that kind of keep the subjects organized. So that's kind of it with the community part. And so now, if you want to search for your perfect kind of waves, this is where you go to this Find Waves section. And you can do this all on mobile too. So it's perfect because it's accessible to everyone, regardless of what phone they have and device. So this is where you can search like for different areas of the world. Like I want to search, let's just say somewhere in Australia, because I want to go to Australia soon, right? So where are the perfect spots for me? So within Australia and region, you have to pick the country, and then the region. I'm just going to leave it as is open because I don't know. I don't know where I want to go in Australia. All I know that my surf style is, my experience level is experienced. I'm experienced. I'm not pro level, but I'm not a beginner. My surfing board, let's just say I want to find, the great longboarding spots in Australia. And then now I'm going to look to see what the wave characteristics. And this automatically filters. You don't have to go and hit a Find Waves button at the end. It automatically updates with each selection that you make. So you can choose waves by world reputation quality. So let's just go for, I just want to look for some regional classics in the area. I'm not going to filter by, I guess there's only two regional classics in Australia. We need to search for more. So where are the world-class ones? World-class longboarding spots. Bells Beach, Burleigh Heads, Snapper Rocks, makes sense. So I want to like have a little bit more selection, so I'm not going to do that right now. Paddle out conditions, if you just want something with an easy paddle out, or you want to challenge yourself and have a really difficult paddle out, or maybe you want to boat somewhere, go off to like this kind of remote spot. And this just kind of goes like, how dependable is this spot? How frequently does it break? I'm not really going to be too picky right now. I just want to kind of like see what's out there. Because I'm really looking for longboarding spots that are really long. But you can look at waves by the direction. If you like a goofy stance or regular stance and you prefer certain waves in different directions, or a wave type. Say you want to just, you're kind of scared of rocks, you love point breaks, you can kind of search by the wave type too. And then the wave power, like you want to go get barreled, look for something that's like, ledgy or hollow. You can kind of search for waves like that. This is what I'm going to search for. I want long waves. I just like to ride them as long and fast as I can. So I'm going to just go super long. I don't want to be too picky. So it looks like, yeah, because the pickier you are, the less options there are. So I'm just going to go like long, long waves, long waves. So I guess it's like Snapper Rocks for me, because the more, criteria you pick, the less options you get. But you can pick waves by height. And then what's cool is you can do by environmental characteristics. Say the swell is coming from the southwest, and you want to see what spots are good for people. If the swell is coming from the southwest, you can search by that. You can search by best tide position for a spot, or the best tide movement. Say that the tide is coming in, you want to see what the best spots are going to be at the current time. And then you can search if something's really crowded or really empty. You can kind of search by that. And then if you're really scared of sharks, you can search by search hazard. Shark protected might be an option in Australia if you want to look at that. And then just kind of like water cleanliness. If you really want to go somewhere that's like Caribbean blue and just have super clean and clear water, you can look at that as well. So, and then the last thing is by seasonality. Say you're planning a surf trip in the month of like June or in June, and you want to go somewhere that has, that's really warm. You can just kind of pick what kind of temperature that you want in a certain months or year. So if I'm going in January, then it'll give me the best surf months in January for spots that have the best surf month there. And then when I'm looking for a wetsuit type, it's also based on this month that you select. So I want to like, surf. Yeah, I just want to wear like board shorts or just my swimsuit, and then in the month of January, and then it'll list out surf spots that are like that. So, there's a lot of complications there. It's like it's a lot advanced. There's a lot of criteria. Most people probably won't even search for that. Most people will just probably search for surf spots in specific geographies. And then you can kind of click on the surf spot. And this is something you need to be, you can kind of see the surf spots and get a little bit more information about them. This is a cool map right here because I've always thought it's great to be able to stay as close as you can to the surf spot that you're surfing. So what this does is this tells you this is Snapper Rocks, and then it shows you the nearby Airbnb and or hotels on Booking.com closest to that surf spot. So it's a really cool way to kind of go and check out and kind of see some different things, see some different places you might want to like visit. So it's kind of cool like that. So I have that in there. And then you kind of go and you can kind of see this is okay, the location information on this spot. And then it just kind of gives you all the stats. So if you're just searching for waves in an area and you just want to know all the stats on a wave, this kind of breaks it down to you in an easy, quick, simple to read version. Just text, no graphical images for you to decipher. And then sometimes it links out to a surf line report or to a magic seaweed forecast. So that's pretty much the basics of this. And then you can also like click out and it'll link to photos of the surf spot, or you can this clicks out to any videos that you may see. And if you're on a phone and this and a location, surf spot has a location. Not all surf spots are identified by location. Some are secret. You got to figure out where they are. But you can hit directions and it'll kind of give you directions. And then this button just kind of clicks out to Google so you can like read more information on it on a certain surf spot. So that's it for the surf spot section. So there you go. You can search for surf spots, you can search for surfers, and then if you just want to do some reading and look at some articles around the way, this is the latest article, a blog I wrote about practical, unique tips on how to improve your surf pop-up, but I still need improvement, but I know what I need to do. It's just doing it, right? So just scrolling through and just some other, surf articles and blogs if you're so inclined, and that pretty much covers it. So this just kind of is a great place, I thought, just to kind of connect with other surfers that are similar to you or even different than you, and connect with them around the world or nearby and find surf spots that are great for you. So I hope you enjoyed this video, and you are excited to check out the website and join the community there. I do have an app, but I'm trying to kind of go get away from that just because it's so dependent on developers and me having to pay like $1,000 every time I want them to like update an SDK. That's something I can do myself on a website. I can just there. So that's why I'm trying to kind of focus here on the website and growing that now. Anyway, I hope you enjoyed it. Have a great day. Surf on. Like and subscribe, I guess. I'll do that, but I don't post a whole lot here. But every once in a while, I do post some things. So if you're curious, want to keep up, that would be cool too. So thanks. Bye.